Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name's Noelle and I do unboxings here, mostly lifestyle subscription boxes, but also some stationery, books, beauty, jewelry, and even a dash of Disney. So if you like unboxings, please do consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell. And if you're already subscribed, thank you so much for being here and supporting me, even with the addition of ads. Today, let's get right into the lifestyle subscription box that I have to share with you. If some of you watched my 1000 subscriber video, you know that it is the box that started everything. Is the one that I first opened on the channel, and that is the Rachel Zoe Box of Style. It is a seasonal luxury subscription that is $99. If you're ever interested in trying out the box, you can get $25 off if you use the link that I will leave for you below in the description. Obviously, there's always a good discount as well if you decide to sign up for the annual membership. What I like about Rachel Zoe's Box of Style is a couple of things. One, you get to see everything that is in the box. Right now, there's no way to skip boxes if there's something that you don't like coming up, which is maybe a reason to stick with the seasonal subscription versus going ahead and doing the annual membership. But everyone gets to customize. There's always one customizable item, and that is available to seasonal as well as annual members, which I just think is really, really nice. The other thing that I used to really like about the Rachel Zoe Box of Style is they always had a very classy, very reusable, nice, hard magnetic closure box, but that seems to not be the case. And I don't think that it's just for this season because of the size of the items that went inside. I did see a sheet then when I pre-scored everything and opened it up that said that they are switching to have more eco-friendly packaging, which I totally understand and can stand behind, but at the same time, I am gonna miss those really lovely boxes, and I'm very grateful that I got in on a couple of them before they made that change. They, like so many other subscription companies, also have a marketplace where you can get a lot of designer items at a discounted price if you are a subscriber, and so I was going into the box a little bit early to see if I got my one add-on item, because it just seemed like even though this is a giant box, you guys, huge box, I wasn't sure how they were going to fit my lovely sun hat in there, but in fact it was in there and it was like crushed. So here is the little Soul Society hat that I got. It's pretty cute. It's got these little pom-poms. It's almost flattened out on the brim. I had it out on the bed overnight to try to fix things, but I was disappointed, even though I think this hat was only like $20, maybe even less than that, maybe like $15. It's huge. Like, and there weren't any sizes, and I have a big head. So if you had like a normal size head, this hat is gonna be way too big on you. Even though I do think the detail is really cute, I wish that this pom-pom band was actually removable so I could put it on one of my other hats. But I guess I could use it if I was like putting my hair up like in a messy bun, and so or like if I had a headband on, which I never wear headbands. But I'm not sad because I got it for such a great deal. I am sad that it got packaged so poorly and kind of crushed. But also that they didn't really tell us like what the size was. It was sort of a one size fits all, and I generally can fit any hat because, again, I have kind of a big head, so usually things are pretty secure, but that one is pretty like slippy on my head, so I wouldn't want to wear it on a windy day. So inside, yes, this is where I saw the message. You can't miss it. So I'll try to show it to you guys. It says, being kind to the environment is always in style. So it says, we've kept the chic and reduced the waste. By reimagining our process and delivering the season's curation in one box rather than two, we've saved enough cardboard to make up the Hollywood sign three times over. This is our first step in an effort to become more sustainable. So again, totally understand that. Also, totally makes me cherish the couple of magnetic closure, like fancy boxes that I did get from them before. So I'm gonna try to pull out everything so I can get rid of this box that just barely fits on the edge of my desk here. So we still have the Hello Gorgeous in there, trying to show you guys. So this is a very awkward sized box, although it would be a good storage box still if you needed something that you could slip under your bed if you have like sort of a low bed frame. I do have a low bed frame, but I'm trying to keep things uncluttered and just kind of get rid of stuff instead of just storing more things underneath. And then they always do a nice product pamphlet that does always include the retail values, which you guys know I absolutely love. Now, Rachel Zoe Box of Style, it's just kind of a side project, I feel like, for her bigger brand. So they definitely have a lot of funding and investors, and that is part of the reason why they're able to get such luxury items. But you are always looking for a pretty good retail return on this box. If you pay $99, there have definitely been times where the box value is like over $500, which I think is incredible. Not saying that some of those prices aren't a little inflated, but really good value, really good turnaround. So here she is. There's the gal, Rachel Zoe. And then they did talk in their social media about how with COVID going on, they had to get creative in terms of their photo shoots to advertise this box. So they actually worked with a photographer whose wife just happens to also be a model. So she did a lot of the pictures. So it says a note from Rachel Zoe, "The summer season for me is all about family, friends, and making memories. It's about enjoying the simple things in life and finding happiness in the everyday. This summer edit has been curated for you with the hope that each piece will bring you joy and in some way be part of your lasting memories. I can truly say that everything in this selection makes me happy, and that certainly means more to me now than ever before." So this is kind of the, I'll show it to you, and then hopefully I can show you and do just as nice of a picture over on Instagram. This is kind of the hero item in the box, and it is the Take All Weekender, and I love that it's just like, it's got that like kind of vintage, almost safari feel to it. Like I feel like I should be going, like I said, on safari. And it's got like this cream canvas and then faux leather detail. Now the leather, the pleather is pretty soft, and it does look, it's a pretty good attempt at leather texture. Doesn't have that nice leather smell. I didn't know that it had like this nice luggage tag where you have a little plastic insert piece, but it is really soft and flexible, and then hopefully it just wears well, because of course sometimes I find that faux leather doesn't wear well, and after like a year or two of use it starts to like peel away, which is kind of a bummer, because then it makes me feel like leather is actually more sustainable because then I don't have to replace the products as often. So nice and big. It's actually bigger than I thought. I love these like little snap details here, so you can actually loop that through here to kind of scrunch it down and make it a little bit lower profile if you don't have a lot of items in it. But I always think bags look the best when they're really stacked full. It does have little gold feet on the bottom. I like that it is that faux leather on the bottom instead of the canvas, because of course with this color, even though it is more of like a khaki, it's like a cream khaki, I don't know what the in between for that is, but it is still looks like it's going to be prone to getting dirty. And then of course, because you have the faux leather, it's not like a nice duffel that you can just throw in the wash, which I would really like. So then they did put everything into this bag, so let me just pull everything out. It does have a nice shoulder strap. I always love when a shoulder strap has this wider band so that it's not just digging into your shoulder, because I tend to overpack. Let me just get this little desiccant pack out. So inside, it is really, really big, you guys. And here I've got two slip pouches, so you can kind of put things inside. And then it does have a zipper pouch on the opposite side. Let's see how the zipper works. Feels pretty good quality, not super like jinky, doesn't feel like it's gonna get caught. It is a slightly different material on the inside. It's kind of like a faux satin though, so I thought it was gonna be more of like a wipeable canvas, but this actually also looks even more stain prone than the outside, and it even looks like there's some like dark spots and stains inside already. So the lining is not like, it doesn't feel like the greatest quality to me. It feels a little bit cheap on the inside, but the quality of the bag is really nice. The hardware, this is a great strong zipper on the outside, which I really, really like. And again, it is huge. You can see it's very, very, very big. So I do like this. I think it's a nice classic look. And it would still even go with like your, you know, your dark luggage. If you have dark luggage, I have like a navy blue away bag, and I think that would look very, very cute sitting right on top of it. The other awesome item is this little pouch that comes with it that matches for your like little things that wouldn't fit in that zipper pocket or the slip pockets that you don't want floating around. So that is awesome. And I'm just gonna pull everything out of this. Again, it was smart that they put everything into the bag for sure. And then again, it has that kind of faux satiny lining. Let's read about it. It says, styling tips from overnight stays to long weekend getaways. Pair it with your comfiest jet-setting sweatsuit or summer midi dress. Its classic silhouette, two-tone colorway, and versatile strap make it a timeless wardrobe staple for seasons to come, no matter the destination. So we always take an annual trip to Catalina, which is just opening back up because it is in LA County. In fact, it was supposed to be this weekend, and we probably could have actually gone because they did start opening up, but we went ahead and pushed our annual Catalina visit out a couple more months, so we'll probably be going a couple weeks after my birthday, but I do think that that is the perfect size for a little Catalina weekend getaway, and it's got that kind of vibe that I like to do. I always like to have kind of a vintagey look almost going there, just because it was the place where the Hollywood elite used to get away. So I kind of like that history side of it. It does say this Henny and Lev Canvas Weekender has a retail value of $159. Why we love it, this getaway essential is as luxurious as it is eco-friendly and resurfaces a familiar silhouette with a contemporary feel. Its roomy interior is the perfect place to stash all of your necessities. So I do really like it. I'm a little concerned about the upkeep. I wish they told us a little bit more about how you could clean the fabric if it does get dirty, because it will get dirty. I do think that that is kind of an elevated price. I would probably never spend $159 on a weekender, but am I happy to have it? And do I like the style? Absolutely. So next thing is the quintessential cover-up. So let me just show you the two colorways. There was this fun coral, and then there was this darker like blues and purples, and that was the customizable item for everyone. Yes, I like dark colors, but I also for summer and spring really love corals. Not pink, but coral and reds and stuff. But we're getting so many coral items in other subscription boxes this summer that I went ahead and chose the darker sarong. So just to have some variation, and honestly, this goes really well with a couple of the swimsuits that I have that are kind of floral and darker. So this is interesting to me because I didn't realize that you can see it's kind of like got that faded look. So I feel like it's just printed on one side, or I guess it's the same on both sides. So I didn't realize, but you could kind of see when it was folded up that it's not like a true black. It's kind of like smoky black, which is interesting because I guess that just didn't show up in the pictures. It's got tassels all the way along two of the edges, the shorter edges. Let's see. Actually, it's got tassels all the way along the longer edges, which is interesting. So here is the shorter edge, and then it goes all the way down to this other edge. So this is fun. Lots of fun ways to tie sarongs or pareos or whatever you like to call them. You can see she did like a whole dress, which I think looks kind of goofy with her like halter swimsuit, but you can definitely do all kinds of things where you like cross it in front of you and tie it around your neck, or you can just drape it around you like a shawl, which is probably what I would do. And it is like this nice lightweight gauzy feeling. Let me see, what is it made out of? It is 85% polyester and 15% cotton. It does say hand wash only and line dry. So usually that just means I put it in a mesh delicates bag and then hope for the best, and then I do line dry it. But this is actually thin enough that it could be kind of a very thick scarf, I think. It might get a little bit bunchy, of course, because of all of the tassels, but let's see. So again, it's like kind of got this like smoky, it looks like the backside of a printed material, and there's no real like dark black going on. So I'm going to get super hot. So you probably wouldn't do this, but you could do it, I think, in the fall if you're wearing like a little blazer. But it's definitely a good item to have, especially if you are out at the beach all day or on vacation and then it does get just a little bit chilly and you just want to cover your bare shoulders. It says, I love a printed sarong and have been collecting them for years. This gorgeous print in rose quartz or meteorite will keep you stylish all season long. Styling tips with so many ways to wear it. Let your mood decide how you will drape the watercolor print over your bathing suit. In a rush to get some rays, tie it around your waist and slip on your go-to slides before hitting the pool. Want to spice it up? Cross over two of its shorter ends and tie them around your neck for a sultry summer dress. The options are endless. Why we love it, the dreamy print was taken straight from the runways of Peter Sum's archives and recolored in tandem with Rachel to create a one-of-a-kind warm weather must-have. So that is pretty cool. It is by Peter Sum. So that's interesting. I like that they made it specifically for the box of style. I am happy that I got this darker print, like I said, because we are getting so many bright corals in other boxes. The next thing, they always do like a beauty or skincare item, sometimes both, is by Grown Alchemist. It is a Hydra Repair Day Cream in Camellia and Geranium Blossom. So it just comes in this very sleek, simple packaging. It says, the hydrating hero. With more exposure to harsh rays in the summertime, it's crucial that I lock in my skin's hydration. This day cream is truly the perfect addition to any skincare routine. Again, very sleek container. It almost looks like it's like one of those metal containers, so it's really gonna be able to roll it up as you use it. although these are kind of difficult to just like have out on your counter because they don't stand up by themselves, but here I will show it to you. It's got lots of print on it. It says, finalize your multi-step skincare routine with a pea-sized dollop of satisfying hydration or wear alone for a skin-quenching pick-me-up. The key to flawless makeup application is a hydrated, properly prepared canvas. After cleansing and toning, gently massage the cream into your skin. Make sure to add a little more to the places that need it, like under the eyes. Now you're ready for a foundation or powder or both. Now to me, that just sounds like so much skincare going on. I'm pretty good. I'll do like cleanser. Sometimes if I remember, I'll use the toner that we also got from Rachel Zoe, and then moisturizer, and then that's it. But I know I'm also supposed to do sunscreen and a serum and all the things, but happy to have this. So far, all of the skincare products that I've gotten in Box of Style have been awesome. It is vegan, eco-friendly, without having to compromise quality and luxury, a safe, non-toxic formula that is as effective as it is clean, and this Grown Alchemist Hydra Repair Day Cream is worth $49. So again, you're getting some really quality skincare products, ones that you might not normally choose for yourself, right? Then we have a beauty product by Kosas, and it comes in this little box. It says, this is the Dramatic Duo. I love fresh and natural makeup looks during this time of year. This cheek palette is just right for adding a little color and glow to sun-kissed skin. A bronzer, blush, and highlighter duo that celebrates a sun-kissed glow far beyond the warmer months. Layer on top of a fully made-up face or swipe on bare skin for just a little hint of color. For a bronzed look, apply the tan shade to the hollows of your cheeks and lightly dab on the crease of your eyelids. Oh, that's good. You can use it on the eyes too. Next, apply the highlighter to the high points of your cheeks as well as the bridge and tip of your nose. This will make for a well-rested, dewy glow. From a brand that believes that taking care of your skin includes the makeup that you put on it, comprising non-toxic ingredients to create pigments that enhance skin rather than cover it. Again, this is the Color and Light Palette in Tropic Equinox, and it is worth $34. So you guys know that I don't get a lot of beauty boxes because I don't wear a lot of makeup, but these seem like kind of lighter things that you can use as a bronzer, blush. I don't use blush a lot because I have rosy cheeks to begin with. Highlighter, again, I don't use that either, but I guess maybe now I have the opportunity to give it a shot. And if I could open this palette, I would absolutely show it to you, but right now it's not letting me, so let's see if I can figure it out. Oh, that's why. So it does have a mirror on the top, and then let me just show you, let me cover it up with the box so that you can see the two colors. I'm not gonna swatch it, but they do look like really creamy, which is nice, and these are good neutral tones that I do think that highlighter will work on my skin. And then I do like that this blush color is a little bit more of a brown color. It is a little bit more red, more peach than it's probably showing up on the camera. And then we have one more item. So again, that was $34. And the final item is a jewelry piece. Jewelry with Rachel Zoe Box of Style is like hit or miss. Like, we've had some like really big statement pieces, and we've had some really like dainty, delicate, elegant pieces. This is definitely more of a statement piece. So I have a ton now of tassel earrings, but I definitely don't have any beaded tassel earrings until now. So here we are. So this is the Adored Adornment. A glamorous statement earring is a fun way to dress up any summer look. I love this version in white as a new favorite alternative to black or metallics. Add these to any outfit for an instant upgrade. Pair with a summer-inspired floral dress and sandals, or amp up your poolside look by adding them to your sarong ensemble. Made for women, made by women, for women, these earrings will make for the perfect plus one or two to all of your summer soirees. And this is by Panacea, beaded tassel earrings, and they are worth $55. So again, I would probably not pay $55 for them just because they look like statement earrings, and you could probably get like a cheaper version of them, but they are really nice. And I do think that white is great for summer, and that's definitely going to show up in my hair. So happy to have these items. The earrings aren't, like I said, I wouldn't probably pick them out for myself. I always like the skincare. I think I've definitely upped my skincare game through the Rachel Zoe Box of Style alone, as well as all of the other boxes that I get. I will try to use that blush, or I might actually just pass it on to one of you guys that uses more makeup, since I don't a ton. These are kind of heavy, I will say. They're a bit heavy. Love the sarong, love the bag. Those are probably my two favorite items in this box. Let me know what your favorite items are, and if you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up, and hopefully I'll see you all very, very soon in my next unboxing.